Good morning. I'm Dr. Howard Lux, sports medicine doctor in Westchester County, New York. Today we're answering another website viewer's question. This question came from Dave from out in the Midwest. He wanted to know about recovery from rotator cuff repair. Dave seems to believe that it's a relatively quick repair because, of course, he heals faster than others. Well, Dave, unfortunately, that's not true. Perhaps some of us will heal a little better or faster than others, but by and large, this is the biology of tendon healing. And we can't really change that. We've tried injecting various substances. We've tried layering other substances onto rotator cuff repairs. However, what we are waiting for is your rotator cuff tendon to heal back to the bone. That means that the body has to grow the tendon into the bone with what's called Sharpie fibers. It takes a very long time for those fibers to grow. So when your surgeon goes into your shoulder, they are reattaching the rotator cuff to the bone with sutures or stitches. Those stitches are only strong enough to hold that tendon against the bone for a short period of time. If you have old or degenerative tissue, then the length of time that the sutures can hold the tendon is even shorter. That's why we put you in a sling, to allow the tendon to rest and sit against the bone without being disturbed so that that healing can take place. Now, it generally takes about 5 or 6 weeks for the healing to begin so that it is strong enough to allow for certain motion and use. We typically call that activities of daily living. That means you can use it to wash, to bathe, to dress, to use a fork and knife or a pen or type at a computer and read a book. That doesn't mean you can help with certain activities around the house. That doesn't mean you can start to throw 50-pound bags of mulch down into the beds outside as it turns to winter. As you progress with your physical therapy, the first goal is to regain your range of motion. You don't start any resistive exercises because that's going to put undue stress on the rotator cuff repair. Your rotator cuff is healed enough to start motion, but not quite enough to begin strengthening at 6 weeks. Most of us wait up to 3 months before starting aggressive strengthening on the rotator cuff. Joseph Iannotti published a great paper a few years ago which showed that many rotator cuff repairs are initially successful, only found to fail somewhere around 20 to 24 weeks after surgery. That implies that we're becoming a little too aggressive too quickly with our recovery from a rotator cuff repair. So, academic surgeons or surgeons who are aware of this literature are really putting off the amount of time from when we start the aggressive strengthening so that you do not become a statistic in that 20 to 24 week group. This is really tough to hear. It's really tough to handle. The recovery from a rotator cuff repair is far longer than any of us want it to be. We are trying to make it easier. We're trying to make it quicker, but we're not there yet. PRP, stem cells, patches, etc. It's not leading to a more rapid recovery. Do not heal faster than anyone else. So give your rotator cuff the time it needs to heal. Otherwise, you're going to find yourself back in pain and perhaps back in the operating room. And the chance of a second rotator cuff repair working is far lower than the chance of the first surgery working. Take care. Bye.